but it's just break the toilet right there where the bolts are holding it down. And it should come right up, and then we'll worry about the bolts. When we start with the flange, it'll be a lot easier to get to. As you can see, this is one of the biggest problems that they have with the toilet, is that the floor is starting to deteriorate. And when this happens, the toilet kind of gets loose and wobbles back and forth a little easier. And that's not good for the wax ring or the seal. So what we're going to do here is we're going to remove this floor and replace it with another floor. A lot stronger, much better, so that the toilet will be nice and stable. Out of there, and we're going to clean up this little spot right here. The flange is also broke, and we're going to replace the flange also. This is an old cast iron flange and cast iron pipe. If you're familiar with the lead and oakum, this cast iron pipe's been put in with lead and oakum, the flange. But we're going to use a new technique when we go to install the new cast iron flange. Melting lead and oakum is not required for what we're going to do. And we're going to finish getting the rest of this floor out. And what we're doing here is cut the inside of the flange so we can just take the flange out of pieces. And what we have here is a side angle grinder. We have a diamond blade on it. It rips right through cast iron, brick, pretty much any hard substance. Okay, now you see that we have it cut. We have you can probably see the little slits in the side. And what we're going to do here is we're going to take our pry bar or whatever we have, and we're going to wedge it between the cracks and just kind of pry it loose. See how it comes right in half, and we're just going to take that old flange off of there. You can see the old lead. And of course, this is a bottom view of the floor that we're replacing, and the toilet collar, that's what it's called. And this here is a repair flange. This is a cast iron repair flange. You notice the rubber in the middle. This is what is going to seal the pipe and the the flange from any leaks from up under the toilet or whenever the toilet is flushed. And it should just fit right over the pipe. If it doesn't, just pull it back up and kind of adjust the screws where it opened up, and you can get it in there. Now, one of the only things left to do is tighten the bolts so that it will compress the rubber ring together, causing a nice tight seal. And of course, before setting the toilet, clean the pipe up pretty good. And screw the flange down to the